too comfortable. Stay familiar with your exit. Stay behind closed doors. Yeah, yeah. Where we can skip the first impressions. One more, one more shot.
Hi guys, welcome back to our makeup channel. Today I bring you this very dark look. I hope that you guys like it from the picture, but I will be showing you how to do this today. And of course, today our special guest is the Huda Beauty Palette. I know I only did one makeup look with the Huda Beauty Palette, so I wanted to do one more here on this channel before I review it. I have been using it though. Don't think I haven't been using it. Like, who buys this palette and does not use it? Like, let's be realistic. I love this palette so far, but I will be having a review on you guys that are still haven't bought it because are not sure if it's worth it or not. So that's what I did today. But anyways guys, let's just get on to the video and let me show you how I achieved this look. Sorry for the lighting. I am working on the lighting so much because I do use natural lighting. However, I want to invest on a, what is that called, a Diva ring light, because natural lighting is a bitch. I'm not gonna lie, like seriously, it goes from dark to light, and you will see on the video, like I changed so many skin tones. It's not even funny. But I hope you guys enjoy this makeup look. Tell me what you think down below as always, and let's just get on to the video.
All right guys, so the first color I'm going to be taking is the color Dusk, and this is a very brownish color, kind of soft, but it does look kind of grayish. Here I'm just starting really slowly applying it on the eye. You will see that I will build it up. These colors, you do have to build them up to what you want, which is what I love because I feel like it's perfect for beginners. The pigments are really, really good and nice and soft. Then I'm going to be taking this reddish color. It is named Duo backwards, I believe. I have no idea, honestly, guys. But I'm going to be applying this color on the crease, as you can see, building it up. This is going to give you a little bit more of a reddish tone because I did want to have like that purpley tone in it with red, very galaxy looking. So I'm just applying this on the crease, really focusing it on there, not really moving it from there, blending and blending and blending. You want to blend and blend, blend so that it looks really, really nice. This is a very simple eye, I would say. I think the hardest part, it is the liner, the gray eyeliner. But other than that, I did use like the minimal colors on the lid. So here I'm just going to be taking my Makeup Forever HD foundation, and I'm just going to be applying it on the back of my hand. And using a thin brush, I'm going to be cutting my crease. Of course, you know it wouldn't be my channel if we didn't cut the crease. So here I'm just cutting the crease, taking my damn time. You do want to take your time. I don't know, but I found it's better to do with foundation than concealer. That's on my opinion. I have no idea. It just depends like what you work best with. So here, as you can see, I already cut my crease. I made it look so easy. Yeah, whatever. Then I'm taking Desert Sand, which is a white color, just to set the foundation before I start applying the other color on my lid. Then I'm going to be taking this color right here, Retrograde, which honestly kind of has like a gray purplish reddish hue to it. It just depends what lighting hits it, to be honest. As you can see here, in some areas it looks gray and then some areas it looks like reddish. It just depends on the color. Here I am taking this liner. I did want this eye to pop a little bit more because it does look sad if you don't have that extra pop. You could even put some glitter, but I feel like I've overdone it with the glitter, so I just use this liner from Tarte, and it is a gray one. I think this is the most hardest part of the look, but you can definitely do it, so don't worry, just take your time. Then I'm going to be taking the eyeliner by NYX, which is my favorito, and I'm just going to be lining my eye, as you can see here, making the liner kind of go up towards like where I finished the gray eyeliner, but not like connected together, if that makes any sense. You'll see right here, I showed you guys the process. So you can see I go all the way up, but then I stop like right when it's going to hit it, and then I just create the wing eyeliner. I did make it a little bit small. Didn't want to go so drastic. Sometimes I like to make it thicker. I don't know. Just depends on the day. Then I'm taking the Lancome mascara, which I've been loving a lot because it's small and thin. Then I'm taking these lashes, which I will leave down below if you guys want to know what they're called. But I'm pretty sure they're the Coco Lashes. No. Are they the Coco Lashes? The Lash XO by Lash XO. Whatever. I'll just leave them down below because my mind is like all over the place right now. Then I'm taking this eyeliner by Tarte and just putting it on my waterline to make it a little bit more dramatic. And then I'm going to be taking the palette, Huda Beauty palette, and I'm taking that purple right there. And I'm going to be playing it on my lower lash line just to give it a little bit more of purple hue in the color combination. I did want it to be a little purplish. Then taking my mascara and enchinándome las pestañas de abajo. You know what I'm saying? Just doing that. Simple, simple. Then I'm going to be taking the Jaclyn Hill palette. And I'm going to be taking that white shadow right there, which has been my favorite to highlight the inner corner. You just need that pop, girls. I love that color for that. Then I am taking this color by Anastasia Beverly Hills, which I will link down below. It is a purple mauve-y dark color. I like it. I like it very much. Especially, I just felt like it just fit the look. And that's what I did for my lips to give me that baddie look lips. You know what I'm saying? I also wanted to add a little bit of blush to me. So I'm just using this trio by Anastasia Beverly Hills. Then I'm going to be using the palette by Carly Bible and applying this highlighter on my cheek. I like this highlighter so much. I think it went really good with the look. And it is super beautiful, guys. And super cheap. Like I've always said, like I really do recommend this palette right here. But that is the finished look, guys. For my intro, I did film it outside, guys. That's what it is. Like kind of weird, but it's just because I get the best lighting outside, so sorry for the background mess, guys.
Well, guys, that was it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup look. I feel like this look is so bad bitch yet galaxy-ish. I don't know how to describe it, but I love the purple. Like, it just makes me feel so bad. I don't know what that means. Anyways, please leave your comments down below. I love talking with you guys. Tell me what you guys did for Thanksgiving, so I can comment back on your comment and I can shout you out too. And give me a thumbs up if you guys enjoy this makeup look. If you didn't, then give me a thumbs down. I don't care, whatever. But I'll see you guys here in the next video. Bye. It's good luck when I'm like, oh, what's up with you? Wrist, 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 whipping in the car with you. Whipping in the car with you.